What's up, guys? Houndish here, and today we're jumping in with some extra Destiny 2 Season of the Chosen info and discussion. So, in this one, we're going to take a better look at how Battlegrounds will be set up, as well as how we'll unlock and target rewards with the Hammer of Proving, and this is kind of going to be like the new Chalice or Cryptolith Lure type mechanic. We'll also talk a little bit about Helm, this is the new Vanguard hub, as well as the return of the Crow, and we get some teasers for Season 13 Secrets, so we'll talk about that stuff, new stasis aspects, the known armor sets, and a bunch of other things in the video, including some clarification from Bungie. So as always, guys, I hope you do enjoy this one, and be sure to give us your thoughts about the season that Bungie have revealed in the comment section, but now, let's get into it. And so yesterday we did speak about some of the new content stuff, but Bungie did post an additional help article. But first, to give some context to all the content, it says in Season of the Chosen, as the Pyramids and Zevorarath continue to destabilize the system, a new force emerges. Empress Keitel, leader of the Cabal and daughter of the deposed Emperor Kallus, seeks an alliance with humanity, but when she demands more than Zavala can offer, negotiations collapse, and Guardians must become the tip of the spear that strikes at her growing war council. And so for the activity, to prove their strength in the eyes of the Cabal, players will need to challenge Keitel's warriors in the new Battlegrounds activities across the system. And we know that there are battlegrounds on Nessus, Europa, and the Cosmodrome at the very least. But it says use the Hammer of Proving to forge and socket Challenger medallions out of pillaged Cabal gold for the right to take on Keitel's fiercest commanders in ritual combat. And so the Hammer of Proving itself is going to be the new Chalice of Opulence type mechanic. And I suppose Challenger medallions will probably work somewhat like Wrathborn targets, and then Cabal gold is going to be a currency. But also, we'll visit the war table at Helm to upgrade the Hammer of Proving through three tiers of pursuits that will unlock hammer upgrades, new proving runes, gear drops, and more. And we get a preview of some elements of the hammer right here. So the proving room, a challenge medallion, Red Legion and tribute chests, and then hammer charge, Cabal gold, and mission focus. Those will essentially be the parameters we can adjust inside of the hammer. And we've seen quite a few bits of gameplay of what these battlegrounds are going to look like. It'll certainly be cool to get some new content on the Cosmodrome as well. But additionally, the Prismatic Recaster is present at the helm. And Bungie say players will need to own the season pass to utilize prismatic lenses, and that's what we need to focus the contents of the engrams. But also, Umbral engrams will once again not give any rewards if dismantled, so bear that in mind. But for Helm, which stands for the Hub for Emergency Logistics and Maneuvers, it's going to be the new base for all current Vanguard operations within the system. And from Helm, players can interact with the War Table seasonal vendor, access the Prismatic Recaster, decode Umbral Engrams, manage their vault, and retrieve items from the Postmaster. So it's going to be a pretty fleshed out area, and it does seem like there's some potential for the War Table to be the kind of main seasonal vendor, or a focal point for new seasonal content and things that are going on. And of course, that's backed up by the story element of the game and the Vanguard's focus on the current kind of major threat. But in terms of where Helm is, it definitely appears to be a last city installation. Bungie did also describe it as a spaceport, and it does appear to be connected to the tower buildings, all the wall around the city, but I think it's safe to say it's designed to be a faster hub space to load into for specific tasks, and we can get a sense of scale for the hub from some of the images shared by Bungie. It's not a massive space, so it is quite bespoke in terms of what it'll be used for, and it's also probably safe to say that it isn't in the tower, because it has its own postmaster and vaults and things like that. That doesn't mean that it can't be part of the tower, right, in terms of the story, I just purely mean in terms of load zone. And either way, the Prismatic Recaster is at the far end, and we can see that here in the image from the Bungie website, with the war table at the other end of the room. We do have more suggestions of how that could link to the story as well, which we'll speak about in a moment. But Bungie also points out that the Season of the Chosen legendary gear will reach its max power level in Season 16, and that during Season of the Chosen, legendary gear from Season of the Worthy is going to reach its max power limit. Also, DMG said clarification, there was an error on the Season of the Chosen page listing Battlegrounds as a match-made activity under the free path. Free players will have access to an introductory experience of the new Battleground activity, but further access requires the season pass. So that's interesting, Bungie will actually give new light players the opportunity to check it out. That will essentially just be a demo version, and otherwise it is season pass content. And once again, before we get to next week, Bungie say, before Season 13 begins, the following quests and items should be turned in, or they will be removed from inventories, and that includes weekly bounties from Strikes, Crucible, Gambit, the Gunsmith, and Crow, and then Crucible tokens, of course, as well as memory fragments for Stasis. So any that you're currently holding onto are potentially going to go away, so bear that in mind. This is partially because Bungie will unlock some new Stasis Aspect quests straight away on February 9th, so players have spotted a couple of abilities in action. It's possible here that we're seeing the Stasis Hunter throw a second scythe, and instead of getting that kind of frozen whirlwind effect, the knife bounces between a bunch of enemies. There's also a clip that looks like a Warlock is charging a Shadebinder grenade up. and then one when we can see the behemoth Titan doing a kind of big striker slam with both hands up in the air, as opposed to the normal one-hand slam that we see with current Stasis. So that gives us a potential idea of some of the kind of modifications that we're going to get for those subclasses. To get onto a couple of lesser noticed things right here though, obviously during some of the story content, the Crow is going to be chilling with Savala. So in this cutscene that we can see, I initially thought it was going to be on Mercury, but it's possible that it's just on Nessus with some very orange lighting right there. But Crow is actually alongside Savala, so I'd say he certainly looks to have an upcoming role in the Vanguard, especially with the introduction of Helm, not only as a gameplay component, but looking at Osiris as Savala's advisor, what is obviously going to be Crow's involvement, and yes, he does have some new kind of white scaled armor, this time with a white bird sigil. I'd say it all looks like it's going to be a kind of wider shakeup of the Vanguard over the course of this next few months. And who knows, maybe we're going to see Crow in the Helm area, or maybe just in the tower, but nonetheless, he's definitely going to be part of the upcoming content. Also, players have spoken about the Cabal ship floating in the dark right here, right at the end of the trailer. And this is where Osiris says there is no light here. We can also see a Screeb in one of the frames. Players did speculate this maybe could be a Season 14 tease like we saw with previous trailers, but Bungie also posted a clearer image of the ship on the Season page, so I think since Bungie have teased that alongside chosen content on the webpage, it quite possibly will be a secret quest or something for Season 13. Who knows, maybe we're going to go and fight some Scorn. There were rumors of Kallus kind of scooping up Scorn in the Forsaken era, so never know, there could be some kind of story link there. But for a final couple of things, in terms of unique activity and season pass weapons, and this is kind of brand new stuff, we know, of course, about the exotic bow and then reprise weapons like the palindrome, but looking in the season pass, we are going to get a sidearm and potentially a linear fusion rifle. But also in the image, we can see a rocket launcher, a sniper rifle, an SMG and a sword, and we spotted these at different points in the trailer as well. They do look somewhat similar to Leviathan weapons from year one, but they have had the models updated, so I'll be curious to see what archetypes and stuff we're going to get. And finally, a better look at some of the armor that we're going to be seeing, but of course there is the season pass armor, so without ornaments, and then with ornaments, where things get rather interesting, that'll be season pass stuff. Also, Bungie did tease the Trials armor a few days ago. And then here, we're looking at potential activity armor, or otherwise Eververse armor for the season. We don't get a very good look at the Warlock, but the Titan appears to have kind of ram or bull horns, both on the helmet but also the shoulder pads. And we can see from the screenshot here, the Hunter with a Shadow Price has got a cloak that kind of looks like a crazy spine or tail or something. So that obviously is going to be a third set, hopefully from the activity content, but we'll have to wait and see. Either way, Bungie have also said that they're going to be bringing 3 new exotic armor pieces into the game that'll drop in higher tier loss sectors, so despite the fact that plenty of stuff's been sunset over the past 2 seasons, it does look like we're going to get a reasonable infusion of new gear as well. But as always, give us your thoughts about it down below. For today though guys, that is the quick roundup of some extra stuff we missed from Season of the Chosen. Obviously not long to go now, so as always, be sure to get subscribed right here on the channel, and I'll keep you posted with that content and any additional info that we get over the next couple of days. Let us know what you think about the stuff that's been revealed, but also if you have enjoyed the video, a rating below really helps us out on the channel. For now though guys, thanks for tuning in, and I hope you have an awesome day.